news at 5 p.m.
And this is a breaking news. Sky 2 live over a barricade standoff in San Clemente.
Desmond Shaw, does it look like this person has anywhere to go there, huh?
Yeah, Juan and Susie, here we are in San Clemente at the east end of Avenida Pico, and it's this black SUV that's in question. This has been going on for close to 4 hours. It started as a stolen vehicle pursuit, didn't last very long, ended at this dead end, and you can see he's completely surrounded by Orange County Sheriff's deputies and their SWAT team. Nowhere to go, completely pinned in. There's just one suspect in the vehicle, but obviously been refusing commands. They have canines out here as well as hostage negotiators. They even have eyes from the air from a little drone. But he brandished a weapon a little bit earlier. Unclear what the weapon was, but it's definitely a concern for the SWAT team as they try to bring this to a peaceful conclusion. But this guy just does not want to surrender. It's going to be a matter of time, and hopefully that will be a peaceful ending when it does finally happen. Live in Sky 2 overhead, I'm Desmond Shaw, Juan and Susie. Back to you in the studio.
4 hours so far. Wow, Desmond. All right, keep us posted on this one. And more breaking news now at 5. Sports stadiums, theme parks, and outdoor concert venues just got the green light from the state on a plan to reopen.
CBS2's Tom Wynn is here now with the breaking details. Tom?
Hi there, Susie and Juan. Well, a lot of people have been waiting nearly a year for this news. Let's walk you through what the state just announced. Starting with amusement parks first, the state says they can reopen on April 1st if the county the amusement park is in has moved from the state's most restrictive purple COVID tier into the less restrictive red tier. Once that move happens, amusement parks can reopen at 15% capacity with mask mandates and...
Why not?